Welcome back into Day Planner. We've got some really big stories making news headlines today, but leading the pack, we continue to track the impacts from Hermine.
That's right. In fact, we've seen the system spawn some pretty wild weather, especially over Texas. And you know, yesterday evening,
severe storms gave one mother the scare of her life. She was driving along I-20 in Mesquite with her three-year-old when high winds suddenly flipped her car.
Grant Stitchfield was just minutes behind that accident and captured the emotional scene.
And thankfully, right now in that area of Texas, things are really quieting down, but we're still concerned about some flooding as that whole mess moves off to the north and east from spring and tomorrow. And then finally by the weekend, getting a chance to sort of regroup and dry out a little bit and actually be pretty comfortable with temperatures into the 80s. Kelly?
Now let's talk temperatures. I mentioned football, and boys, it's starting to feel like football weather in some areas.
And you know, it is encompassing also. We got college, we got NFL, of course, high school.
That's right.
High school games going on, whether you're the Friday night lights or maybe your Saturday morning games. Here's what we're looking and what we're dealing with. Of course, for Friday, across the South, where maybe you've got those Friday night games, it's gonna be sticky, it's gonna be hot. And for those after school practices, for sure, we've got temperatures in the 90s from Atlanta over into Dallas and Oklahoma City. Nice and cool, pleasant as we roll into the weekend for the Northeast. We're talking highs in the 60s and 70s. For Boston, New York, and over into Philadelphia. State College as well by Saturday. But the big game, of course, in my opinion, is Penn State versus Bama down south. We're talking about definitely humidity, maybe a few showers for Saturday. We have to keep thing we could call extremely hot. Temperatures close to 100 degrees for Phoenix.
Now let's
BP released the results of an internal investigation today. The controversial report outlining what the company believes led to the deadly explosion. We are just moments away from a complete check on the tropics.
That's right, new information.
It's 50 past the hour in time for the tropical update, and I feel like I've been saying this all season, but we've got a lot cooking right now.
We certainly do. It is September after all. We want to bring in our hurricane specialist, Brian Norcross, who's tracking a couple of things. We've got new information on Igor from the National Hurricane Center, but you're watching something a little closer to home.
Yeah, the one in the Caribbean, only because of where it is.
BP. All right, Brian, a lot going on and a lot of players at play, so I'd like to say thank you so much.
Always this time of year.
From players in the tropics. To players on the field. Football season getting underway, so is our kickoff forecast getting underway here on the Weather Channel. But not only do the football players and fans have to brave the elements during some games.
Oh, yeah. Well, the weather players, too. The meteorologists like Mike Seidel. Here's a look at some of the best of the worst. It didn't look like you were buying it there. You're like,
Okay, Mike, whatever you're saying. We're going to have more of Mike and doing some tailgating again this season,
yeah,
so we look forward to that.
Definitely. Well, looking forward, of course, PM Edition is coming up later this afternoon.
Vivian Brown and Nick Walker will be here to discuss the top weather stories, of course, from all across the country, including the very latest on what's left.